Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to demonstrate and describe about the frequency modulation and demodulation trainer kit. By this trainer kit, we can study the frequency modulation by using the different frequency and the carrier signal modulation techniques, and also we will demodulate the modulated signal through the circuitry as well. So now we will move on to the circuit description and the basic theory related of the FM modulation. In this, the FM is and the frequency modulation is a basic modulation technique in which the frequency of the carrier signal is modulated in accordance with the signal amplitude, and the output amplitude will not vary in this as per the amplitude modulation. And the FM modulation is more accurate and more precise. By this, the distortions are reduced of the amplitude modulation, and nowadays frequency modulation are much higher in use while working with the communication techniques. So we will also verify the frequency modulation and explain different circuitries given in the user manual and also on the circuit. So we will now move on to the experiments of the frequency modulation. So this is our trainer kit of frequency modulation and demodulation. The order code for this trainer kit is 40502. You can use this order code to do the queries about the frequency modulation and demodulation trainer by visiting our website, which is the www.tescaglobal.com. So now we move on to the circuit explanation. The frequency modulation demodulation circuit is described here, in which there is the modulating signal are given. This is the DC amplitude, a toggle switch which changes the modulating signal to DC and audio signal. The audio signal amplitude and frequency can be changed by these knobs provided here. The output of the modulated signal can be get on this terminals of output terminals. Now this terminal will be provided with the modulating signal input here, as given in the user as given in the kit, and this will input will be compared and converted with the frequency modulation as requirement. The circuit of the frequency modulation with constant source buffer and sine converter are provided on the front panel. Also you can study the circuitry in the user manual also is given. Then this output will be provided with the comparator, and the comparator will give the FM output on this FM output terminals. At this terminal we can get the FM output here. And for demodulation, the demodulation circuit is also provided around this. So the FM output can be provided on the FM input here, and then the demodulated output will be get on the demodulated output signals by using the diode OA79. We can also find the modulation reference index, and we'll also perform the different experiment given in the user manual. So now we will move on to the experiment section. For before that, I am also explaining, we are also offering the user manual in which all the details about the frequency modulation techniques are considered to study, to better study and experiment. And experiments are also given in the user manual, and we are also giving the patch codes to do the connection in the accessories purpose. You are also required a CRO or a frequency counter, and you can use the DSO also for this purpose. So DSO will do your both the work of waveform output, showing the waveform output, and also counting the frequency of the modulated output as well. Or otherwise you can use a CRO and a frequency counter also. And in the last experiment we will also use the audio frequency generator for the demodulated output, and then we verify the plot, and then we plot the graph of frequency demodulation. So now we will perform our first experiment, which is to observe the effect of DC voltage on frequency of carrier waveform. For this we will follow the procedure as given in the user manual also. So the first step of this procedure is saying that we will first connect the socket marks modulating signal out to the socket marks modulating signal in, and we will keep the switch towards the DC and keep the amplitude of at the minimum position. So we will first connect the signals of modulating signal output. Here this is the carrier signal, modulating signal. This will be connected with the modulating signal input with the help of patch code. So we will connect both the sockets as described, and we will connect a CRO on the FM output terminals to see the output of this waveform. So we will connect the output on the FM out terminals, and now we will power on the circuit, and we will first make sure the signal is at the DC position and amplitude is at minimum. Now we will power on the circuit here and observe the output on the CRO. So we will auto tune the CRO first. So this is giving the sine wave output. We will adjust the amplitude also. So now we will change and slowly increase the DC level of control voltage, and note the frequency of the carrier signal changes. Right now frequency of the carrier signal is showing is about 20 kilohertz. Now we will change the DC signal through the knob also, that will change the frequency of the carrier signal also. You can observe the frequency changes on the CRO as well. So this is the maximum DC signal as I provided. Now at this time we will observe the frequency output is 12 kilohertz, approx 12 kilohertz as described in the CRO. So as I increase the DC level of the input, this is decreasing the frequency of the carrier signal. So this is the effect of modulating signal on the DC. The DC signal, DC voltage of the signal will change the waveforms and the frequency of the frequency modulating signal. So this is the basic concept which is used in the modulation circuits. Now to perform the second object or the second experiment, we will do the frequency modulate the carrier with the audio signal and observe the FM waveform on the CRO and also measure the modulating index. So with this we will follow the procedure. First we will feed the modulating audio signal by keeping the switch on the audio position and to the sockets connected with the marked modulating signal in, and observe FM output on the CRO and vary the amplitude and frequency of the audio signal, and then we see the FM effect on the output. So for this we will do the connections. First we will connect the output and modulating signal input, and we will turn this switch to the audio. So this is the amplitude of audio and the frequency of the audio signal. Now these are will be modulated according to the frequency. So we will connect the CRO at the FM out terminal. So right now at CRO you can observe the frequency is right now very still, and as I increase the amplitude, this will start the modulation with the carrier signal. And this is the amplitude as I am increasing right now. So as I increasing the amplitude, the modulation is also increasing, and now I will increase the frequency level slightly. So this is also changing the frequency, and amplitude is also changing the vibration in the sine wave, which is the carrier signal, and this is the audio signal which is modulating with the carrier wave, and this is the effect of frequency modulation. You can also adjust the CRO in accordance. Here I am increasing the amplitude slightly, so you can see the better frequency modulation output. Now amplitude is maximum, frequency is maximum. Here you can see the output is frequency modulated. You can decrease the amplitude, this will decrease the frequency modulation output. Also you can decrease the frequency as well. So this is the effect that you can observe on the CRO of the frequency modulation. Now we will do follow the next step, which is first we will disconnect the audio signal and measure the frequency of carrier waveform with the frequency counter connected between sockets marked FM out. So we will first disconnect the input signal from the FM circuit, and we will remains the CRO connected on the FM output. At this time we will see the frequency of this signal. So this is showing, I am using the DSO, so this is also giving me the frequency. If you do not have the DSO, only have the CRO, you have to use a frequency counter to calculate the frequency of this carrier signal. So right now frequency is 22 kilohertz of this carrier signal, and this will be considered as FC. So for calculating the modulation index, you need to note down this frequency of the carrier signal. This is the frequency of carrier signal, which is 20 kilohertz. Now we will follow the next step. Again we will feed the audio signal to the modulating signal in the sockets, and then observe the FM wave on the CRO, and we will note down the maximum frequency of a part of the FM waveform on the CRO, and we will let this frequency is F maximum. So we will now connect the audio signal again to the FM circuit and change the frequency accordingly, and observe the highest frequency that we can get on the CRO. So I am getting here 28 kilohertz as the maximum frequency. So this is the 28 kilohertz right now. This is the F maximum we can observe here. So the frequency will continuously changing, but you can observe the frequency which is the maximum frequency on your frequency counter or a DSO, whatever you are using. So this is showing me the 27.3 kilohertz is the highest frequency. So I will let it the F max, and now we will find out the calculated frequency deviation by using the formula given in the user manual, which is the frequency deviation is lambda is equals to f max minus f c. So by using this formula you have got the carrier frequency, which is 22 kilohertz, and the maximum frequency is 27 kilohertz. So this is around 5 kilohertz you will get the deviation. Now we will connect the frequency counter on the socket's mount marked modulating signal out, and then we note down the frequency of the audio signal, and then we will let it the FM. Then we put the all values by lambda by FM to find out the modulating index. So we will take out the CRO probes from FM out terminal, and also we will disconnect the signal, audio signal, and we will connect the CRO on the modulating amplitude also. So I will now auto tune the CRO, and this will giving me the frequency count right now, 585 hertz. So this is the frequency of our audio signal. I can change the frequency and amplitude. So this is the minimum frequency from this, 520 hertz, and we will consider the maximum frequency for this. So this is the 585 hertz is the f max of the modulating signal. Now you can put the values in the formula for finding out the modulating index. You can get the modulating index by using this formula. Now moving on to the next experiment, which is to demodulate the FM signal and observe the output on CRO. So for this we will follow the procedure in continuation with the above experiment. Connect the FM output terminals with the FM input sockets of the demodulator circuit, and we will observe the audio signal on CRO between the socket marks demodulated output. We can adjust the level accordingly to find the better demodulated output. So for demodulation we will connect the signal. First we will give the modulating signal to the modulating signal for FM frequency modulation, and this output signal will be connected with the demodulation circuit. So FM output will be connected with FM input, and we will connect the CRO or the DSO on the output terminals of the demodulated output. So this will give us the demodulated output. You can change the frequency and amplitude. Now we will auto tune the CRO. So we can change the frequency. So this is our demodulated output. You have to lower down the voltage per division, and also you have to vary the frequency and amplitude to get the better results of the output. Here you can see, for getting the proper and actual demodulated output, you have to adjust the frequency and the amplitude of the demodulated output here. So this is the demodulation output. You can also observe the frequency of this demodulated output is same as the input carrier signal frequency, that is 580 across. This is about the 580 hertz frequency, and this is the demodulated signal of output we can observe on the CRO. So now we will going to do the last experiment, which is to plot the characteristics curve of the slope detector of demodulating circuit. For this we will follow the procedure as described in the user manual. For this we will connect a audio frequency generator across the socket's mark FM in. For this we will first give the demodulator circuit input as a frequency generator, and then we connect the CRO across the secondary of the demodulating circuit transformer, that is the anode of diode OA79. At this we will get the CRO waveform, and we will take the readings of input from frequency generator and output across the secondary of the demodulating transformer. At various frequencies we will let the frequency between 1 kHz to 40 kHz as per the following table, and then we plot the ratio output upon input on y axis against the frequency on x axis as the graph sheet. So this is the observation table at which we have to take the different readings. So this is the input frequency from 1 kHz to 40 kHz up to, and then we see the input peak to peak voltages. This will be remains constant, and output peak to peak will be whatever we get, and then we get the output upon input ratio of amplitudes, and then we will find out and do the frequency slope of detector, slope detector converter in the FM and AM signal. So this is the frequency generator at which we have set the frequency of sine of 1 kilohertz. Here you can see, and the amplitude is about 4 VPP. We will remain this amplitude constant, and we will vary the frequency from 1 kHz to up to 40 kHz by step to get the different frequency ranges, and this input will be provided on the circuit of our FM demodulator circuit. So we will provide positive and ground on the circuit, and to take the output we will connect the positive of this test probe at the anode of DOA1, and the ground will be connected with the ground. At this time you can observe the output on the CRO is the same as we given. So this is the 1 kHz frequency given on the output also. You can measure the amplitude. Of this signal is 162 millivolt as given on the CRO. You can take all the values. Now we will increase the frequency to 2 kHz or 3 kHz. So we will take the measure steps. You can take the frequency on each kilohertz frequencies, each 1000 kilohertz. So now I am taking the value to the 5 kilohertz, keeping the amplitude same. Here the output is 5 kilohertz also you can get in here, and the amplitude is right now increased slightly, which is the 213 millivolts. Now again we will increase the frequency to 10 kilohertz, and at this time the amplitude is also increasing, which is now 250 millivolts. So by continuous process you can take the different readings. Now I am increasing the frequency to 15 kilohertz. So we have to adjust the CRO amplitude to get the approx. So the frequency is 15 kilohertz and the amplitude is right now 550 millivolts. So you have to take down all the readings from all the steps. Now I am changing frequency to the 20 kilohertz, and at this time now you can observe the amplitude is now decreasing again. This is showing 360 millivolts. So this will decrease the amplitude peak to peak output. Now by getting all the readings from up to 40 kilohertz, you can take down all the readings in the observation table, and then you can do the calculations as described. You have to find out the output upon input ratio, and then you have to keep this ratio on the x axis, or you can keep this ratio on the y axis, and the frequency 1 kHz to 40 kHz on the x axis, and then you will get the graph. This is the balanced slope detector characteristic graph. The graph will be similar like this given in the user manual also. If you get the same graph, your experiment will be considered successful. So these are all the experiments given and described in the user manual. You can do all the experiments as described in the user manual or also as described in this video as well. So this is how we do the all experiments given in the user manual with this trainer kit of frequency modulation trainer. And you can do all the experiments as I described in the video also. And while doing the experiments, if you find any difficulties, you can refer the user manual for all the details. Study and the theory are given in the user manual. If you get stuck at any of the experiment while doing the readings and taking the readings, carefully and properly read the manual to do all the experiments, follow all the procedure properly. And apart from that, if you find more difficulties and you want to get some more details about this kit, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all the supports. Thank you.